In this particular mechanism, we have a body 2 here, which is rotating. And as it rotates, this particular body 4 will be oscillating. And at this point, B, body 5 is connected to body 4. So what happens is that this body 6, at point C, is moving along the horizontal. And this is just reciprocating. So in this particular instant, let us look at that point. There is a point A, which is in body 2. There is another point A, which is in body 3. And there is another point A in body 4. So they are coincident at that particular instant, at that point. Now, in the analysis, we'll have to encounter, of course, relative velocity, which is just the sliding velocity of this body along that body 4. So in terms of vectors, if we have this as the vector that represents the velocity of A in 2, which is just equal to omega, yeah, this is omega 2 multiplied by O A, we have a sliding vector, sliding component of the velocity, and that sliding component of the velocity is that the relative velocity of this body 3, A3, or body 3, along that body 4. So that particular component of the velocity is actually the velocity of that point. So that is the velocity of that point, which we know must be perpendicular to that point A4, O2. So with that, as the velocity vector, we can make this proportionality rule. And we know that the velocity of point B now is given by that vector, velocity of point B. If we have to determine the velocity of C by resolution and composition method, we can transfer this vector here. And along the horizontal, we can draw that line, which will represent the velocity of the point C. That is the velocity of C by resolution and composition method. But somehow there is, we know that this is the axis of velocity of that point or that value 4. So if we may have to extend this and make this vertical line, there has to be another point here, which is the axis of velocity of body 5. The instantaneous axis of velocity of body 5 at this position here. So with that, we can make the arc that passes through the point B and transfer this vector here. Again, we will transfer the vector, that is the same vector here, and we can make the proportionality line. So that again, we confirm that that is the velocity of point C. Now making a relative velocity method on this particular part of the component of the mechanism, we can just make this velocity, transfer this velocity of the G. The velocity of C is along the horizontal. And the relative velocity of C with respect to B must be perpendicular to that BC. So with that, we can make this parallel line. This line is parallel to this line. And we do have an intersection here. This is our origin O. This is our velocity of C, as this is our velocity of B. By the way, this is the velocity of C with respect to B.